think that I would start talking to myself and being a little angry, you know. So they just have a hard life, you know.
How did I end up?
Mm-hmm.
Heartache, depression.
There.
So how did you end up here?
Drugs.
She abandoned my son and I.
I'm a natural motherfucker.
To Florida.
Okay.
And she came back 7 years later.
I used to drink. And I couldn't stay with my family, so that'll bring problems, you know? So I choose the streets.
And she went to court.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
And got guardianship. I became depressed.
Okay.
Well, I was doing crack cocaine. I was doing LSD. And I was drinking 24 hours a day, you know. I'd lost my job. I didn't have a leg to stand on. All I had was a pair of pajamas and $45 to my name. That's all I had.
Oh, wow.
That's all I had in life.
How long have you been on the street?
6 years.
1980.
Yeah.
It was around the end of the Vietnam War.
Mm-hmm.
What year exactly?
1972.
Yeah.
All these pictures right here are my graduation from boot camp.
Someone was a proud electrician.
Now I'm out here.
Made $94,000 a year. But I have nothing to offer.
It
takes your fucking self-esteem right away.
That's true.
They found me, the ambulance found me in the alleyway. I woke up, I had an oxygen thing on me. I couldn't quite understand what actually happened, and they told me. They said, you fell off the fire escape. I broke two of my ribs. That was my last.
A lot of people are on the streets religious.
You got to believe it.
Yeah.
Oh, for Jesus. Wow.
Horrible, huh?
So do you have any willpower left? I said, no. I have none whatsoever. See, it's the willpower that keeps you sober.
What made you change?
God and Jesus, He led upon my heart. I really believe that. And I really changed a lot in the year and 7 months. It's even helped me to stay sober this long, and I never stayed sober this long.
I don't know how to get out of it. My rut's so deep. I don't know how to climb.
I want this fuck.
I really mean that.
Fire.
Go. Help him get a job or a trade and get situations, get a job so they can get on their feet, help them, give them a helping hand. You know? I mean, not to stay with them forever, but
yeah.
Help them kind of get going, you know. Maybe it would help the curse of homelessness here.
I scratched a lottery ticket.
Oh,
I won $5,000. I was sober, that happened 2 summers ago, so I was sober 7 years. And I called up my therapist. She says, oh, David, she says, you know, money's the biggest trigger. I said, why you say that? I said, why do you have to put that on me? I said, I'm not even thinking about drinking the drug right now. I'm thinking about clothes and food and, you know.
The strange thing is I do have a happiness in my soul. Somewhere deep inside, people try to squash it, goes over here. They try to squash it over there, it goes down here. You can't squash this light I have, because it's gone. For Jesus.
And you're hopeful?
Of course, I'm alive.